Hey guys, learn some catch-jitsu. Dan the Wolfman here, gonna teach you everything about advanced guillotines. You're gonna learn all kinds of different guillotine positions and different ways, variations of the choke. So pay attention to all kinds of grips. I'm gonna start standing, then I might go to the wall cage, taking it to the ground, then I go from the knees, I might show different positions. We're just gonna talk about grips. So we're talking about everything other than a basic wrist blade of forearm guillotine. So number one is going to be, if I snap this guy down, we're wrestling, boom, I snap him down, I get a chin grip. So from here, this position is usually where I'm gonna handle all my kinds of guillotines, from the feet, or I snap them down, we go to the ground, to the front sprawl, front turtle position. Okay, so right now I'll just show from the feet. If I snap them down and I got a chin grip, 10 finger guillotine. Grab them up here just for visuals. So I'm gonna just rotate this in and I crush them there, okay? So here, and here's just a 5-finger guillotine. I'd roll this in, but I don't have enough control over his body. Here I'd have to do 10-finger, and there. So I'm really rolling this kind of under, and it's not really the throat. I'm really rolling it to like the tongue area, like under the mandible. It sucks, it's really bad. So this is a 10-finger guillotine, guys. You just cup it like a cup and saucer, and you roll it up. Okay, next would be a power assist guillotine. Power assist guillotine is, instead of this grip, or even if you have this grip, you can rotate your hand underneath, turn up the volume, palm up, and push it up. Now this is really, really nasty. Good for standing, good on the ground, good on the knees. John Jones did this to Ryan Bader on the ground, and he did it to choke out Lyoto Machida on the feet. So here, this is how John Jones does it. Okay, so even if you have this grip, especially against the cage and stuff, or you just snap the guy to the front turtle position, I can rotate it up. So there's power assist guillotine. Then there's figure four style catch wrestling guillotine. Not so good standing, better on the ground, but I'm just gonna show standing so you learn the hold, the positions. I'm gonna palm strike this shoulder, push it back, and I'm gonna figure four here, and I'm gonna choke right there. Okay, similar to the face crank, not a guillotine, but face crank slash neck breaker right there. That's a free pop. You okay? similar, okay, but the first one was on the throat. So that's a figure four. And then there's high elbow. Now you can do high elbow from this grip. I don't have long arms, so I'm not great at a high elbow. Or you can go to a reverse butterfly or a pretzel grip with the thumbs out or with the thumbs in, perhaps. Because I'm not long to elbow, I feel like I can actually get my elbow deeper over his shoulder if I do a reverse grip. And we've seen both ways. On the ground and standing up in the UFC and prelims, there's been a reverse grip. There was at the last one fighting championships, there was a high elbow as well, pushed against the cage, kind of standing against the cage, driving in. So I could go here and I could throw this over, okay? Or I could go palm the palm over. See, I feel that's way better, tighter, obviously. Or I could do it with thumbs, I'll do that one. I could do it with thumbs if you prefer. I think I like the thumbless grip. But I could go here, here. Now what's great about those is you don't need, it's the only guillotine you don't really need any kind of guard. I can fall to side now, Marcelo Gracie style. I can get a scramble and I'm still gonna choke you out in the scramble as long as I keep this blocked out over the shoulder. Now one of the big advantages standing up to this one is typical guillotine standing up defense is hangman. If I do a high elbow, try and throw that over, I can't, and I choke him out. Okay, so there's the high elbow guillotine. So these are all different guillotines. Above and beyond that, there is the catcher arm through guillotine, which you can hit from standing if I stuff this through. So guys, you gotta learn all the different guillotines. If that arm's through, Ryan Bader style, I can hop this to a reverse lockdown from standing. So anytime I got a snap down on the guy, I can knee his head if it was MMA, and I can bump this around, and I can get to here. And if I'm around the corner on the guy, I can jump here, throw in a reverse lockdown, boom, and now I just stretch him out. Okay? So that is a catcher arm through guillotine from standing that you can take to the ground. Another one I could take to the ground, you can take high elbow to the ground on transition off his takedown or whatever, or jump to it if you had good arms for the high elbow. I'm going to show another one. Come to the cage over here. Guys, just do your best to pay attention to the grips. This is the similar reverse butterfly grip or pretzel grip, you might want to call it, standing up. But with the arm in. So it's similar to how I did the high elbow, but I'm going to do it with the arm in. So guys, pay attention. One arm in, one arm out. Here. So I got this. Okay? So now that I got this, I can actually, it's the one thing you can actually do to half guard. Of course, you have to have that same side half guard, not opposite like most people do, and then it's never really a danger of a guillotine. But if it's same side, Rogério Negreiro's got it in Pride before, but this way it actually becomes a legit submission against someone good if you have this reverse grip. Okay, so now I can fall in here and I can pull them and stretch them out. Is that a tap? One time. Okay, and if I could, I'd get a lockdown in there and I can really stretch them. Okay, so I can throw that lockdown and stretch them out. This becomes a totally legitimate guillotine from half guard. So if we're in a scramble on the ground and he's passing whatever, but I happen to be over here, like maybe he just stuffs his knee. I can switch to the reverse grip and he stuffs that knee and he thinks he's just passing. I throw in a lockdown and now I got this reverse grip, he's dead. Okay? So this grip, nasty. With the arm in, you can actually do an arm in guillotine from half guard. You don't have to have full guard because of the grip difference. It shoves it in a circle, the neck. So, these are all kinds of cool different guillotines. Now guys, pay attention, please. Learn the grips, and then we'll go over them. From the knees, from the front headlock position. Okay, a lot of times if I just snap the guy down or he just tried a double leg, these guillotines, some of these are very good to go to right off the bat. Because he's in wrestling mode, boom, and I sprawled on him. Or I snapped him down. Now instead of trying to do something else fancy, just kill him quick with a quick guillotine. Because I have body weight control over him. And that's what's going to isolate his head and his throat for the kill, is that I'm on top of him. I'm over him. So let's say I just sprawled or I just snapped him down. If I go to that 10 finger right here, but I stuff his head to the center of my chest, boom, he's dead. Okay, because he can't go anywhere. I'm just cupping and lifting, but my body is trapping his head. So instead of trying it off on the side here, I'm gonna just shuck his head to the center, cup, and go. Okay, and you see I can make it even worse if I pull my knees in. So I go here, yeah, go kind of low if you can. Put it in knees. So I'm going to put it to the center, and then I got my cup, and now I'm going to slide my knees in and compress his neck. Here. Okay, you got to watch a really strong wrestler taking you down, possibly, but if you do this kind of slide in knees finish, it's bowing his neck into his chest. So I'm here, and instead of just this, if I go slide in and I go here, it's a much worse compression, right? Okay. So there's the 10 finger, which you can make a 5 finger. I'm getting really good at 5 finger guillotines from Mao. So 5 finger is just one-handed guillotine. Next is just sprawl on the guy, just snap him down, boom, power assist. Just quick kill him, just lift up to the center. Just extend and yank the guy up, but keep some body control over him. So that's just a horribly quick kill from here, and no one does it from the front turtle, front headlock position. That figure four catch wrestling style, that figure four one works better. I just snap them down here, come here, boom. Okay, so this one works better from on the ground, on the knees, in the front turtle. High elbow. So I'm here, this grip, or better yet, I like this grip now, I like this reverse grip, I throw this over. Here. What's great is if we scramble and he comes around, whatever, he's still getting choked out on the way. You okay? I know it's kind of slow. It'll toughen you up to the ATS. Try to pass the side on this time. We'll see. If I can keep this over his shoulder, so I'm here, sprawled out, whatever, I go here, reverse off his chin. I like that chin strap right away. Here, throw this over. Let's say he starts to pass. I'm going really slow with pressure. He's passing it. But because this is still over his shoulder blade, I got the tap out with no guard. Legs are not involved. So that's certainly a huge advantage to that guillotine. Now, talked about it before. If I got that arm in and I'm trying to go for a regular arm in guillotine, boom, I go here. but stuff that knee because I didn't get it all the way through.
Uh-oh, it's probably no good, right? Here, while I'm doing all this squeezing stuff, you see? Switch your grip to the reverse grip. It's not that hard. Right now, I'm double palm down, if you can see in here. And then I switch, throw in my lockdown, stretch them out. Okay?
Reverse butterfly grip, or some people call it parental grip. I forgot. Catch your arm through guillotine. So, boom, we're resting. Snap them down. Wham! I'm here. I talked about this in another video. I'm going to try to Schultz choke him. Schultz choke him. I can't get him. He's going to drive in. Try to take him out. Whoop, I come in here and trap him. There's my catcher arm through guillotine, which is very different, in my opinion, than the other ones. It's the one I really feel comfortable going to my back end to get someone good because I have good control. It's a quick tap. And even if for some reason, which the other day I had trouble tapping out my big Kazakhstan guy, because he had got his elbow to my hip bone instead of right on the side of my ribs. He got his elbow to my hip bone. So even if he defended, I pull this one, whatever. With the arm through here, I have two videos on this one already. And whether it's this grip, because I tried Schultz choking first or this grip, I'm here. For whatever reason, my knee's not deep enough. My shin shield on this other side isn't deep enough. Go to the other side. Relax, relax. Yeah, and he start to go. Man, I can bail. I can bail on this one. So that's why you see guys like alpha male fighters use that in the UFC a lot. And it's a very quick kill. So there's a whole lot about these advanced guillotines that people don't fully understand. And I'm gonna do one more that we didn't talk about before. Let's go standing and go to the ground. I don't know if this is a ninja choke or a front naked choke or my combination of the above, which I think it is, which in my opinion becomes a guillotine. Instead of a front naked choke, trying to just chop down on his neck, which would be something like this, and grabbing, and then trying to scissor down to make pressure. I don't think this is that strong, though certainly can work. By arching here and stuff, that can certainly work, so there's another one, okay? But this would be better. If I had longer arms, it would be even better. If I stuff through and try to get my elbow down here, ninja choke style, here, okay? But I'm on this other side, and I managed to attach. Now I'm here. Now what I do is I finish it the way I teach a rear naked, is I pinch my elbows together. So now this becomes a really horrible, just like I teach a rear naked. I teach a rear naked differently than a lot of other people. I'm not teaching this, I teach compression first, elbows together. You see he's almost out, and then I just add a little bit. So I make it a structural thing first by pinching my elbows together. We do the same thing from the front. So I'm in here, I come in deep, I come here, and I pinch those elbows together. So, I'm in that front headlock position, or even in a dog fight. I could be in a dog fight position, and I'm in here, and he's here, and we're going, whatever. I can come over here. Now, I might be able to get the tap right here, or even if we roll, he's gonna roll to defend. I might stay on top and roll. And I can keep it here, keep it here, keep it here. And if I don't lose my grip. Kind of similar to how Ellenberger got Josh Kasha. One from the front turtle there. So boom, we're down, sorry. Here, we go from here. I'm gonna shoot this deep. Try and get your elbow like a V down to the bottom of his neck. Okay? Come on top, front naked choke stat. And I'll pinch the elbows together and curl that in. So now he's getting it on the arteries and everywhere. A full compression. I think that pretty much covers it. It's a lot of stuff, it's a lot of different grips, but learn the advantages to the high elbow. Learn the advantage to this pretzel grip, which you can use as your high elbow and go to this. Learn how that catcher arm through guillotine, look at my other video, how it relates in there and mix from the Schultz choke to the Peruvian necktie to the anaconda, how those go together. I have a whole series on, instead of this front stuff, a whole video on if I shoot this through, 4/5, maybe 6 submissions, I can get from there, a whole nother video on that. And then there's combination guillotines and compressions and accordion choke and all kinds of other stuff. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe and I will catch you on the flip side.